Hello guys, welcome back to my channel san&nasTechie, and this is the ninth video tutorial under Python scripting for storage admin. And in today's video we will discuss how we can convert a Python file into a binary file or a .exe file. So far we have written a script which will log into two devices which support SSH protocol and collect the current version of those system. So we will convert this particular file into a .exe file. So the question is why we need to convert this Python file into a .exe file. So we have installed Python in this particular system and we have also installed the Paramico module, and now we are running the script. So the script is working perfectly. But suppose if you want to run the same script in a different Windows machine, then you have to again install the Python and all other modules as well, which will be a hectic. If you are converting the Python file into a .exe file, you just have to copy that .exe file to a different system, and in that Windows system you will be able to run the script with that .exe file. One thing we need to keep in mind, that if the system where we are converting the Python file into .exe file is a 64-bit operating system, then the binary file can only be run on a 64 operating bit system only. Same is applicable for 32-bit operating system. So before proceeding further, I have a request to you guys. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that whatever video I upload in this series or in this channel, you will get notification immediately. And if you came to this video directly, then I would suggest to go through my previous videos on this particular series so that you will be able to understand what we have done so far. So let's proceed further. So in order to convert the Python file into a binary file, we need a module called pyinstaller. So in order to install that module, we have to type pip install and then pyinstaller and then hit enter. So I have already installed this particular module, so it will show that the requirement is already satisfied. But if you have not installed this particular module, then you will get some different output here. So if you have followed the installation process that I have explained in my second video, then this process will happen easily for you guys. If you have not, then I suggest you guys to go through the second video where I have installed the Python scripting language. As we can see here that the requirement is already satisfied, so I can proceed further for converting the Python file to a .exe file. So first of all, we have to go inside that directory where our Python file is located. In my case, it's under desktop and then inside a folder called py2.exe. And here I have that Python script, that is info_collector.py. So in order to convert this .py file into a .exe file, I have to type pyinstaller and then the script name, that is info_collector.py, and then I have to type --onefile so that the .exe file will be bundled into a single file, and then I have to hit enter. So it will take some time, maybe 30 to 40 seconds based on your system speed. And once this process is completed, we will get our .exe file. So here we can see that the process is completed and we have also the location of our .exe file. So I will just copy it and go to that particular directory. This is our .exe file. So I will just copy it from here and paste it in the previous folder where I have the crad.csv file, so that we will try to run it and see if the .exe file is working correctly or not. So in order to run this .exe file, again you have to go to the command prompt and let me execute the command dir here to see if the .exe file exists or not. So if this exists, and in order to run it, I just have to type the .exe file name, that is info_collector.exe, and then I will have to hit enter. So the script has started running. Both the two devices are downstate, so definitely we are going to get some error. So the purpose was to show that the .exe file is working as expected. So the first device has been executed and we already got an error that the connected party did not properly respond after a period of time. So the same thing will happen for the second device as well. So that's all for this video. I hope you understand why we convert the Python file into a .exe file. If you have any questions or comment or suggestion, you can put it in comment section. And once again, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that whatever new video I upload, you will get a notification immediately.